Yeah, good morning, everyone. First of all, thank you to the GITS and Tech2D for having me. I'm actually very excited. The two speakers before me were talking a lot about, let's say, a more theoretical thoughts about innovation and how we can drive innovation, maybe also come to a more sustainable future. I would like to give you some examples of my group. We are a group of architects, designers, artists, sculptors, and I'm actually also very happy to be here today because most of the time representing our company, I talk to people who ask me, what's the business model? How can we get profitable with 3D printing? What's the magic behind it? But honestly, and I attempt to be very honest to everyone, I don't care about these things so much. I'm more interested in creation and coming to new things. So just give you a brief background, and if you Google me, maybe later you will find that the beginning of my career 10 years ago was really tempted around how can 3D printing enable a more sustainable production and a faster design cycle. So this piece you see here was called the Glacier Chair, and the idea behind it, it was published quite some time, was that through 3D printing we are able to use the last amount of material, because you don't take away material, you add material, and at the same time you use biodegradable materials to do that. So there's a lot of potential in this. Another example of this, where we are at, is basically here. You see that you are able to design, you have biomimicry, you can look into nature, think about the most efficient structure. So this study basically underlines that you are able to just build up material, you are not carving out material, and you could also not manufacture this in another way. So we are really interested in how can we use this technology to come to new designs and also maybe to a more sustainable way of production. And it's actually very strong. For some of you here in the room that are material scientists, this is a PLA material, so a material that's not related to be the most, the strongest one out there. So, but with a clever design, you could come to these kinds of structures. And you see, like, this creates also attention. We were quite out there, published also with these kinds of things. This is the Chancellor, I think, of Switzerland, Ms. Merkel, a few years ago at the Hannover Messe. So there's an interest about it. But at the moment, and this is what I really want to point out, for me, 3D printing is just another tool in the manufacturing chain, another instrument in the orchestra. It's not magic to, from the beginning, kill this to everyone, right? But if you are smart, you can come to things which I always call the unseen, the unexpected. I love this. I'm bored by people coming to me, I have this injection molded part, can we also 3D print it? So in this case, we experimented with a kind of a conductive material, and that was printed. So you are able to somehow embed a kind of an annealing sensor technology into a part. Coming back to your sustainability, you are able to then also reduce lead times, reduce logistic chains, reduce all these kinds of things. So we have to think about this, not about trying to mimic parts that you can do with any other manufacturing technology. And then, and this is quite often the case, what we do, we then transfer a lot of these knowledge into it, into industry. So in this case, we work with Daimler on actually trying to bring this knowledge that we created in our group into these kinds of parts. And you see here that the beauty of it, you can at any point put in electronics, put in sensor technology to basically also have a digital traceability of your part over a life cycle, which I think is very, very interesting. And these two sensor areas here, you are able then to switch on and switch off lights. And you can basically use this for all kinds of applications. In this case, it works with touch, because it's really about the way we work is you have to come up with ideas, be creative, and then you have to find people that are interested in accelerating this. So in this case, we would really need a Fraunhofer, a research institute, or somebody with a big interest in pushing this, helping us to create a material that has a higher conductivity. And you see, I'm very, very application related. This is not because I want to make a pitch of what we can do. I really want to try to give you a heads up on what this has for an impact in the sustainable world. This is a headrest of an old IC train from the German railway. And you know, sometimes they don't have these parts in stock. The tools are gone. You don't know how to manufacture this anymore. So 3D printing is a very effective way to reproduce this, but this is not my point. My point is that if you think about it, and this is what the German railway did, for example, in collaboration with us, they screened all their spare parts they have in stock, and they have spare parts in the volume of 5 billion in stock. So if you are able to reduce this amount just by 10%, this is a massive cost saving for them, but that's also not my point, because today I want to talk more about these sustainable aspects. The point is, you have a digital, basically, database, and all of a sudden you don't need a warehouse anymore, and you don't need logistics flying parts around the globe, or in this case, flying parts around Germany. So this is valid for all kinds of industries. You have basically your digital warehouse, and basically time and space traveling will be cut off, and you produce locally. And this is also accountable for, let's say, sustainable developments in regions like Africa or South America. You are able to manufacture locally. And there are a lot of aspects around that where I'm very, very interested in. And if there is somebody here, please come up to me. Because topics like ocean waste, for example. At the moment, we have this problem that ocean waste is a massive problem. And everyone who knows chemistry knows that it's a potpourri of plastics. You cannot just melt it together and then make a new filament for our printer out of it. It's a little bit more difficult. You have to find a solution to sort it, to come up with these ideas. And that's what I'm very, very interested in, because then you are able to, basically, you have such a machine, and again, I don't care about the machine. It's more about the thoughts behind it. What can this mean for a more sustainable world? This is also another example of coming back to the innovation. This is a partition for an Airbus plane that was developed by some colleagues at Airbus and Autodesk to basically save material. So this is a 13G partition where the stewardess normally sits. And this is like 50% weight and material reduction by the same structural performance. So there's this other point of talking about digital technologies. You are able to basically simulate a vast amount of iterations that you could never come up by yourself, right? That will have basically will enable you to be structurally more valid, and at the same time, come up with cool designs that you also maybe don't cannot think of in a conventional manner. And so Airbus, at this example, they were saying, like, we always looked in metal, but we figured out that metal is still too expensive. So now they are also looking into polymers. And my interest, and there is a lot of things going to happen in the future, is that there are natural fibers and there are biodegradable materials. But the problem is in the heads of the industry. The industry wants their ABS oil-based plastic, right? Because it's certified. So the change process has to start in the industry. We have to really think about how can we overcome these materials. If you say, okay, this material has the same performance than ABS, should be able to implement this, right? And I just give you some examples and always try to hint of some of the thoughts around this. So this is basically another technology where you don't feed a filament, you feed a stock of pellet, of granulate. So there are two things concerning sustainability. One is really this idea of being able to have a part basically shredded into pellets and recycle it, have a kind of a cradle to cradle. You cannot do this so often because polymers tend to degenerate. So I'm not a chemistry guy, but that's what they say. So this is one example. And the other example is really, can we come up with an idea to basically pick up the waste of these companies, or also globally, pick up waste, trying ways to sort it and make it into anything that you could extrude to make new things out of it. I will rush through this because I see my time is running out, because I just wanted to make another point concerning, and this is my fun point, talking about innovation. This is ABB. I don't want to make any kind of advertising for them. A few years ago, I was interested in using this cobot. It's a coaxial robot that they developed to basically pick a screw and another screw, put it together, put it away. But actually, this thing does not really work. It costs 80,000 euros, and it does not really put any value to the production. So I called them up, and I literally say, you can't believe it or not, but I said, you are old, you are big, you have a lot of money, but you are not innovative at all. You know? And I said, we are very young, talented, creative, but we have no money. Give this to us for a certain time. And this is what we came up with. So we were trying to put robotic handling together with printing. And this is also another point in this value chain. If you have, let's say, a kind of a sustainable way of manufacturing already today, there's no need to use 3D printing for that. No, not at all. You have to be creative and basically try to combine these things. And this is what I tend to call hybrid manufacturing. And you see it here. So this robot arm will print basically like a human on these parts. That's me talking about it, but let's wait for a second. And then we should see it moving. This is in our lab. If you are in Berlin, come by. I'm more than happy to welcome you. Okay, whatever. So here you see it. The thing is, it really, you are able to print on non-planar objects. This is a little bit nerdy, but it's actually really cool, because it allows you to take any part you have from your production, whether it's injection molded, and it costs a few cent, it is certified, no need to print it, but you can basically have a value add to it. And I think this is the thing that where you need this creativity. I, at one point, read in the magazine called Brand 1, I will not translate it into English, but it literally said, in Germany, creativity is always under Spaßverdacht, which means, you know, these crazy creative people, you don't get taken for granted, but I think it's exactly this. Taking the old corporates, taking the Gits, taking all these players into account, putting them in one room with some creative people and come up with new revolutionary solutions. That's the only way how we can overcome, how we can make our world better, I think. And then just as a quick last thing, so we always try to bring this into industrial standard. So here it's again, we work with an airline together from the Middle East, and they are very progressive in terms of implementing technology and wanting to go a new kind of way. And this is my last statement because the clock says 5 seconds. Please, Germans in the room, let's be more open, let's fail, let's fall, let's stand up, and let's make the world better. Thank you.